Okay, so we are talking about divide and conquer technique. So it's a design technique. So it basically has three steps. One is divide. So we have given a problem of size n. We divide the problem into sub problems. So that is the divide step. And then, so we have the sub problems which are lesser size, which is not now in n. So which are lesser size. Now we solve the sub problems. By recursively solving them. So, that is the conquer step, and then once we have the solution of these two sub problems, then we combine the solution of the sub problems to get a solution of the whole problem. So, this is basically three fundamental steps of any divide and conquer technique. Like in Mart-Short is an example of divide and conquer technique. What we are doing, we have an array of size n which need to be sort. Now we divide this array into two sub array with equal size, I mean lower ceiling or upper ceiling n by 2. Okay. Then we, this is the divide step in Mart-Short. This is the divide step in Mart-Short. And then what we are doing? We are recursively sorting. So this is a sub problem. We reduce the problem. Our problem is sorting problem. We reduce this problem size to from n to n by 2, n by 2. Now, at the, that is the divide step. Now, at the conquer step, we sort this sub array, we sort this sub array recursively. So, that is the conquer step. But when we sort this sub array, this is a sub problem. This is also a sorting problem, but the size is not n, size is n by 2. So, we call same Mart-Short on this, same Mart-Short on this. Okay. Now, that is the conquer step. Now, once you have a solution for this sub array, that means once these two sub array are sorted, then we call what is called merge subroutine. So, that is the combine step. This is the combine. So, we have a solution of two sub problems, then we solve, we get the solution of the whole problem by the combine step. So, this is the way, this is three fundamental steps for any design and conquer technique, and we have seen few example like binary search, powering a number. So today we'll talk about two more example which can be handled by divide and conquer technique. Today's problem is, first problem is Fibonacci number. So problem is to finding Fibonacci number. So what is a Fibonacci number? So it start with 0, then next Fibonacci number is 1, and then next one is add these two, previous two. So, 1, then 2, then 3, then 2 plus 3, 5, 5 plus 3 plus 5 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 5, 13, and then 13 plus 8 is 21, like this. So, this is the sequence of Fibonacci number. This is called say 0th Fibonacci number, f 0 we denote, f 1 like this, f 2, f 3, so on. Okay. So, what is the formula? Formula is f n is basically 0, if n is 0, this is the, I mean first Fibonacci number or the 0th Fibonacci number, 1, if n is 1. And then after 1, we have the recursive formula like f n n minus 1 plus f n minus 2, if n is greater than equal to 2. So, this is the formula for nth Fibonacci number. Okay. So, f n is basically f n minus 1 plus f n minus 2. So, last two Fibonacci number will give us the nth Fibonacci number. So, our problem is to find the nth Fibonacci number, where n is another input. Say we want to find 51th Fibonacci number, we want to find say 2078th Fibonacci number, like this. So, this is the problem. So, our problem is to find the nth Fibonacci number. So, how to do that? So, that we can just see how we can solve this problem. What is the algorithm we will use for this? So, the problem is to find nth Fibonacci number. Find nth Fibonacci Fibonacci numbers, nth Fibonacci number Fn. Okay. So, that means we have to find Fn, where n is also an input. So, how to do that? So, what is the Knave approach? So, it is a bottom up method. We start with the first Fibonacci number, that is 0. I mean, we just keep on calculating f 1, f 0, f 1, f 2, and every time we store the last two Fibonacci number. Okay. And then f n minus 1, f n minus 2, and then we got f n by adding these two, f n minus 1 plus f n minus 2. So, this is our nth Fibonacci number. So, this is the bottom up method. We keep on calculating the Fibonacci number until we reach to the nth Fibonacci number. So, this is basically a bottom up way, and so this each time we store the last two Fibonacci number to get the next Fibonacci number. So, what is the time complexity for this? So, this is basically linear time algorithm, because we are just calculating up to nth Fibonacci number like this bottom up way. So, this is the linear time algorithm. So, now we want to do, we want to see whether we can have something better than this linear time, whether we can do it in logarithm time like this. So, that for that we can use some formula which we know about the Fibonacci number. So, that formula is basically telling us the nth Fibonacci number f n can be written as phi to the power n by root 5, where phi is basically 1 plus root 5 by 2, and this is basically what is called golden ratio. This number is called golden ratio. Okay. Where from this is coming, this we can prove by induction, and this is coming basically by solving this recurrence. So, we know that f n is basically f n minus 1 plus f n minus 2. Now, if we take this as x square, this is basically x plus 1. So, if we have this x square minus x minus 1 is 0. Now, it has two root, one root is this. So, plus 1 plus minus root 5 by 2. So, that is why this phi is coming. So, it can be shown that f n is phi to the power n by root 5. Now, we want to see how this formula can help us to have a algorithm. Now, this is also similar to powering a number, but here the number is not a integer. We have seen, if you have an integer like a to the power n, we know this is a candidate of divide and conquer algorithm. We can write this is a to the power n by 2 into a to the power n by 2. If n is even, else we have seen this is n minus 1 by 2 into a to the power n minus 1 by 2 into a, if n is odd. This formula we know, this is basically give us powering a number, but here a is basically a integer. But here also this is also similar to powering a number, but this phi is a real number. Real number. So, problem with handling real number, when we find out powering a real number, then the problem will be in the round upping or in the PC sum. Suppose if we calculate this phi to the power n by 2, phi to the power n by 2, suppose this is a point 3.01932 like this, and this is say 7.119325. So, depending on how much round up, so this rounding and precision will take some time to fix. So, this algorithm is not as simple as powering an integer. So, that is why we want, so that is why this will not give us a logarithm time algorithm, because this fixing will take some time, more time. So, this is the reason we will try to avoid this powering a real number. Okay. So, this formula is not helping us. So, now we will try to see whether we can have another kind of formula which can help us to find out the nth Fibonacci number. Okay, so that formula is basically, we will have a theorem on that. So, this is the theorem on the Fibonacci number. This theorem is telling f of n plus 1, f of n, f of n, f of n minus 1 can be written as 1 1 1 0 to the power n. Okay. So, this is the theorem where f n is the nth Fibonacci number. Fibonacci number. So, it starts with f 0. So, we know f 0 is 1. So, what is the base case? Base case means, so this should true for all n greater than equal to 0. This we have to prove. Now, what is the base case? Base case is if we put n is equal to 1. So, if we put n is equal to 1, so this is true for n greater than equal to 1, because if n is 0, then f minus 1, there is no f minus 1. Now, Fibonacci number is starting from f 0. Okay, so we start, the base case is we put n is equal to 1 and we see whether it is true, the result is true or not. So, this we will see by the method of induction. Okay, so for n is equal to 1, what is this matrix? This is, we put just n is equal to 1, this is f 2, f 1, f 1, n is equal to 1, this is f 0. So, this matrix is basically, we know f 2 is 1, f 1 is 1, f 1 is 1, f 0 is 0. So, this is true for n is equal to 1. So, the result is true for n is equal to 1. So, the base case is satisfied. Now, we need to take the induction hypothesis, where, so induction hypothesis step, we assume that result is true for n is equal to k. So, that means, we assume f of k plus 1, we put n is equal to k, f of k, f of k, f of k minus 1 is equal to 1 1 1 0 to the power k. So, we assume the result is true for n is equal to k, and now we need to prove that, we need to show that result is true for n is equal to k plus 1. Then it is done for, we already proved the base case, that by the method of induction, this is true for all n. Now, how to prove this? Now, to show this, so this is our assumption, induction hypothesis. Now, we multiply both sides by this right hand side matrix 1 1 1 1 0. So, f of k plus 1, f of k, f of k, f of k minus 1. So, 1 1 1 0 we multiply, and then it will be 1 1 1 0 to the power k plus 1. Okay, so now what is this matrix? If we multiply this with this matrix, so this will be basically, so this with this, so this will give us f of k plus 2, and this will give us, so this into this, so this is basically f of k plus 1, and here f of k plus 1, and f of k. So this is basically this into this f of k. So, this is to be 1 1 1 0 to the power k plus 1. So, that means the result is true for n is equal to k plus 1. So, we assume the result is true for n is equal to k. So, from there we can show that result is true for n is equal to k plus 1. So, and we have already proved the base case. So, that means by the method of induction we can say the result is true for all n greater than equal to 1. So, this theorem is proved. So, this is the proof of this theorem by help of mathematical induction. Okay. So, this theorem is true. So, if we have this theorem, how this theorem will help us to have an algorithm? So, that we will see. So, for that we just, so this is a, okay. So now our goal is to find f n. We need to, so this is our goal, we need to find f n. What is f n? Okay. Now, to find f n, we have this theorem. Now, if we can have this to the power n. Then if we can have this matrix result, say this is A, B, C, D, then our Fn is, this is basically, this will be same matrix, because this is basically, this is basically by this theorem Fn plus 1, Fn, Fn, Fn minus 1. So, from this result we can take this as Fn. So, done. So, if we have to find F of say 2017, so what we do? We just need to get this 2017. So, this will give us some matrix, 4 by 4 matrix, and this will be our F 2017. Okay. So, now our problem is reduced to the problem of powering a matrix, but here the matrix is a 2 by 2 matrix, not a n by n matrix. We will see in the next problem is the matrix multiplication, but it is just a 2 by 2 matrix. So, it is very similar to powering a number. So, we can apply the divide and conquer technique to have this this matrix to the power n, powering a matrix. How? So, that is basically the same divide and conquer formula which we have for powering a number. Here we have a 2 by 2 matrix. So, we need to find out a to the power n. A to the power n can be written as a to the power n by 2 into a to the power n by 2. If n is even and if n is odd, it is basically n minus 1 by 2 into a to the power n minus 1 by 2 into a. If n is odd. Okay. So, now this A is a just a 2 by 2 matrix, 1 1 1 0, it is a 2 by 2 matrix. So, now this is the formula for divide and conquer approach. Now, so we have a problem of size n. So, we have to find a to the power n. So, we reduce the problem in size n by 2. Now, we need to find a to the power n by 2. Now, once we have the solution a to the power n by 2, once we have this matrix a to the power n by 2, that is the conquer step, by conquer step, then we multiply by itself to get a to the power n if it is even. Otherwise, if it is odd, we calculate this and we multiply this with a again, I mean this with itself as a. So, either 2 multiplication or 3 multiplication. Then what is the recurrence? Recurrence is we reduce the problem into sub problems, but we have only one sub problems. And this is the cost for doing this multiplication, either 2 multiplication or 3 multiplication, but all the multiplication on the matrix of size 2 by 2, because once we get a to the power n by 2, this will be again a matrix of 2 by 2. So, if you multiply 2 matrix of size 2 by 2, so how many are this? So, I think 8, so we are multiplying 2 matrix, 2 by 2 matrix. Okay, so, say A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. So, what is the result? The result is basically this into this A E plus B G, this into this A F plus B H, this into this C plus D G and this into this. So, C F plus. Okay. So, this is the result. So, that means how many what? So, we are doing just this is real number addition. So, we are doing 4 addition and this is real number multiplication and 8 multiplication. So, all together will be some constant time. So, that is why it is theta 1 and if it is odd, we have to take another matrix. So, that is also in constant time, because it is just either 4, 5 or 4 addition and 8 multiplication, but real number multiplication. So, this will all take constant. So, this is a theta of 1 time. So, this will be same as recurrence is same as powering a number. So, this will give us by master method log n base 2, okay. Sorry, n log n base 2. So, this is the nth Fibonacci number finding. So, once we got this a to the power n in this time, once we got a to the power n means 1 1 1 0 to the power n, then this will be some a 4 2 by 2 matrix. So this is say some number like a b b c. Now this quantity will give us f n. So to find f n we just need to power this matrix. This matrix is 2 by 2 matrix. So this will take logarithm time. So this is the finding the nth Fibonacci number. So next problem we will deal with the matrix multiplication problem. So this is the next problem we will talk about, which can be solved using the divide and conquer technique. This is called matrix multiplication problem. Matrix multiplication. Okay, so basically suppose we have two matrix A B. So A is a matrix, this is a general matrix, say A11, A12, A1n. Suppose this is the m cross n matrix, A21, A22, A2n. Okay. Now AM1, AM2, AMn. So any matrix can be written as in this form. This is if we want to implement this, this is a two dimensional array of size m into n, sorry. Okay. Suppose we have a matrix A and we have another matrix B, which is say of size say, to have two multiplications. So if we have a matrix A which is size m by n and another matrix is B which is size m by p, then we can multiply this. So this will give us a matrix C which is of size m cross p. So what is the formula for that? So this is basically, if we have a matrix n by p, so this is basically b11 b12 b1p b21 b22 b2p. So bn1 n row p columns, bn2 bnp. Suppose we have this matrix. Okay. So then the what is C matrix? C will be again the matrix of size n cross p. So this is c11 c12 c1p dot 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 cm1 cm2 cmp cmp. And this is basically, this is if this is the ith row jth column, and this is basically cij. And what is the formula for cij? Cij is basically we take the ith row of this and we take the jth column. This is the jth column of this. So cij is basically inner product of these two. So cij, small cij, is basically summation of aik into bkj. This k is varying from the common 1 to m. So this is the 1 to m cross n, n cross n. So this is 1 to n. Okay. So this is the formula for cij. So this we know, this is the definition of matrix multiplication. So now we want to have a we want to know how we can have the algorithm to solve the, to have this matrix multiplication. So here for the simplicity we will take all the m n n are summons, same. So that means we take the order of the matrix, both the matrix are n cross n and b matrix also n cross n. So the c matrix will be also n cross n. So basically we have two matrix of order n cross n and n cross n, then we have to multiply. So this is A matrix A I j n cross n, and we have B matrix B I j n cross n, and then C will be the A cross B. This is the matrix multiplication. So this is C I j, this will be also n cross n. So we are just taking for the simplicity the matrix order of n cross n. Okay. So now Cij is basically summation of Aik Bkj k is equal to 1 to n. So, this is the formula. So, now what is the code? The standard algorithm to find this. So, this is the standard matrix multiplication algorithm to find this. Standard algorithm for matrix multiplication. So, now how we can get this Cij? Basically, this is basically we can write in a loop. So, we have, so basically we need to find Cij. So, we have two loops, I is equal to 1 to j, and we have a jth loop, j is equal to 1 to n, and then we assign Cij to be 0 initially, then we have another loop with k to find the Cij. So, this is basically for k is equal to 1 to n. So, this is basically Cij is equal to Cij plus a I k into b k j, that is it. So, this is the pseudo code for finding Cij's. So, we have a matrix, two matrix A B. So, this is the matrix standard algorithm for matrix multiplication. So, this will give us a Cij. So, this will give us C matrix, which is basically A into B. So, this is basically Cij n cross n, because our matrix are all n cross n matrix. So, given to matrix, this is the standard code for matrix multiplication. So, what is the time complexity? Basically, we have three loops each of size n, and this is what we are doing in constant time. So, this is basically the time for this is order of n cube. So, this is the standard runtime for matrix multiplication. So, this is a naive approach. Now, we want to see whether we can use some divide and conquer technique to handle this problem. So, that we will do in the next class. Thank you.